Alright guys, we are back! Camera cut off just as I was about to enter this room, but that's okay because the final boss is through this room anyway, and I was gonna save a part for the final boss and credits as usual anyway. So let's unpause and go! Uh-oh! Holy crap! Get ready for a one-way trip to Davy Jones's locker! Oh boy! Alright, obviously the object, pick up a bomb, throw it at him. Got it? Yeah. That's just about it, actually. Just dodge his tornadoes, his hook attack, his gun. Whoa, there's the hook. And whoa, that bomb's gonna explode. And yeah, he's a pretty dang hard boss, actually. Definitely the hardest in the game. But still not that hard if you know his pattern. And oh boy, he's gonna chase me, isn't he, with the tornado thingy. And by the way, he's completely invincible in tornado mode. Why he doesn't stay in tornado? Oh boy, shake free. If you get caught by the hook, you can shake the control pad to get free. If he's invincible in tornado mode, why wouldn't he stay in tornado mode all the time? I mean, come on. Bosses are just stupid in that regard. Oh, and he also called some buddies over. And sometimes when he's sitting up there, he shoots his gun out. Like, oh, no, he's not gonna do it. Not right now, at least. And, oops, my bad. And obviously you can kill these guys with bombs, but at the same time, you're better off throwing them at Pete sometimes. Whoa, whoa, ow! There goes one of my lives. I don't care, though. I'll just kill you. There we go. Yeah, don't stand too close to whatever you're throwing the bombs at, because the bombs, obviously have a little explosion field, and, you don't really want to be caught in that. So, yeah, since bombs are your only ways of throwing stuff at him, and you have to be close to him, and yeah, there's not much you can do but to be careful with the bombs. Oh, he's gonna sweep the bottom, isn't he? Yes, he is. Every once in a while, he does that really quick sweep towards the bottom of the screen. Whoa, there's the gun. Yeah! Okay. And that gun is definitely the most dangerous weapon he's got. But it can kill these guys that are out there, which is actually quite handy. Maybe he'll demonstrate it this, yes, he will! Just like that. He is not very loyal to his servants, that's what I gotta say. There we go, that takes care of that. Get rid of that bomb, because it's gonna explode. Throw that, I missed. Went right under him, oh man. We're waiting, and he's gonna bounce across the walls, and he's bouncing, and bouncing. Ryan, you want another bomb, please? That would be very nice of you. Thank you! There we go. Oh, that's it! Wow! Woo! Yep, that's the end of the game. Alright, that took us 15 minutes, 32 seconds for that final area. But you won't believe this, but I'll explain it towards the credits, but I actually took 22 hours to finish this walkthrough.
Well, we got the bad guys. I wonder where Pete and PJ are. I sure hope this was the right pirate ship.
I hope the pirates didn't make shark food with them.
I can't read today.
So, somebody get over in here and help us! Hey, that sounded like Pete. Go on.
Oh God! Oh no! They're serving a Mr. P and PJ combo platter to that alligator.
That's strange. It's not even dinner time yet.
Help us!
Give me a hand here, Max. Let's reel him in.
And the alligator goes hungry. Or does it?
Nothing like a relaxing day of fishing, huh, Max?
Right, Dad!
And, yep, that's pretty much it. This'll show us the bad guys of the game, so you guys can watch this while I explain what happened between this part and last part. This was by far the most annoying walkthrough I have ever done. Not because the game was hard, not because it took that much of a long time, but because I ran into so many problems through the way. As you've seen back at part 2, the blooper reel, not really a reel, but just a blooper part, we had some storms that knocked out the power for a split second, which made me lose my progress on this level that you're watching right now. And then later on, the batteries, like maybe in part 5 or so, the batteries of both sets of batteries of the camera that I had ran out. So then I had a spare set for part 6, I believe. I don't remember exactly how it went, but then how did it go? I'm trying, having trouble remembering, because this was actually yesterday. We had both sets of our batteries run out, and I wasn't able to finish the walkthrough yesterday, as you've seen where I left off on this, the last part, and this part right here is where the batteries ran out, and today is where I charged all the best sets of batteries. So it was absolutely impossible for me to finish the walkthrough yesterday. So instead of this walkthrough taking about an hour, which is what I was expecting, it took about 22 hours. So I had to leave the game overnight to keep my lives and whatnot, you know, just keep my place, make it easier for myself. So I really gave the SNES a workout these past few days between Super Mario World and, wow, they got torched. Super Mario World and Goof Troop, but I was in the mood for a walkthrough. Whether that turned out to be good or not is up to the camera and the power outage, obviously, but whatever. And so yeah, that's about it for my story. And we're just, yeah, looking through the enemies of the game. There's Red Skeleton, Blue Skeleton, most obvious names ever. But the red one kind of looks pinkish, if anything. And those are awfully fast for the size that they're at. Because if you remember that boss, they got faster. Whoa, they just got owned. They get faster as you reduce their segments of their body. Wow, Max just got owned. They suck at dodging Pete. Anyway, and there's Keelhaul Pete. That should be the ends of the... Oh, there's Mr. Jamaican guy. Islander, you can call him. And we got some minecart action. I didn't show you this part because this was on that alternate part that I did not show you back in that fourth area, the cave area. And I don't know, maybe I'll show it another day. It's just such an annoying area, I don't even bother going through it, so... Yeah, and that's about it for the enemies and the walkthrough itself, yeah. I can't believe it's finished. I was expecting to run into some unknown problem during this part, but I guess not. Another day brings new luck, I guess. But whatever. As for the storms, according to the news, we had some, not that I watched news, just what I happened to actually catch. It's that we actually had some storm damage in the area, some broken limbs and stuff like that, but luckily nothing around our area, but some cleanup was annoying for people. But that gives you an idea of how bad the storms we had were last night, and I probably shouldn't have done a walkthrough. Maybe I should have been like cowering in the basement or something underneath a mattress. Well, we're running low on camera, but I believe the credits are coming to an end anyway, so I guess that's the end of this walkthrough, as I said.